Have anyone else wishing to speak in favor of this, please step forward. I guess he doesn't, so. Okay, is there a motion? Anyone wishing to speak in opposition to this application, please step forward.
Good evening, Commissioners. My name is Claudia Castro. I'm the current Deputy Director of Smart Growth for Forsyth County. And that was a lovely presentation, very well done, pretty picture at the end. Missing from Mr. Smith's table of contents is, why is this a county-initiated rezoning? Can you answer that question? Why is this county-initiated and not applicant-generated, owner-generated?
Counselor?
I believe the Board of Commissioners at a work session previously authorized this to be a county-initiated rezoning. So okay, whatever the minutes reflect.
The reason I bring this up is that a county-initiated rezoning appears lax in terms of paperwork and all kinds of information that would normally be found on your e-status section online. The application itself is highlighted by not applicable, not applicable, not applicable, not applicable to each and every question practically that is asked of the applicant being the county. There's no staff technical review regarding this project. There's no informal staff report that, at least that we can, as General Joe Public can see, we've not been able to review anything of that sort. And the environmental concerns regarding this type of an undertaking have not been addressed. I've watched the two work sessions where the attorney for the developer, Mr. Butler, presented both in August and September. I'm not certain of the dates right now, but mentioned on a number of occasions that this particular county-initiated rezoning might lead to the dropping of lawsuits that the county is currently involved with respect to this particular property. Mr. Butler also mentioned that he spoke with the neighbors, that the neighbors have been contacted, so there is a developer type of representation, there is a neighbor or a public type of participation, and concern, but there is no concern and no representation for the existing environment. So as Smart Growth's mission, which is to come to a balance between developer, public, and the environment, we find that the third portion of this application is missing. There is nothing regarding the environment. This property sits due north of Browns Bridge Road and I believe is in close proximity to Six Mile Creek, which empties into Lake Lanier. What do you know? So what exactly do these types of businesses that are being proposed for this property, what kind of impact will they have on the Chattahoochee watershed of which we are now so greatly concerned? So it is Smart Growth's recommendation and request that this particular county-initiated rezoning be postponed, at a minimum be postponed, until such time as there is a technical review and an environmental review that can really be studied and undertaken, and some, you know, some back and forth can go on with regard to that. So at the very least, we would request a postponement to give everyone a chance to review all this material. I believe there are some new zoning conditions, or there's a whole host of zoning conditions that were not on the e-status this afternoon when I went online to pull everything off. It certainly doesn't exist there. And at the most, Smart Growth for Forsyth County would request that this county-initiated rezoning be withdrawn and that the developers, the owners of the property, come before this county, come before this board, and proceed with normal and regular rezoning application that follows all the due diligence that our UDC requires. Thank you.
Ms. Castro, when did you find out about this project?
I've actually been watching things online, trying to, on the e-status. I'm always going on because this is 115 acres of a least intensive to a most intensive use. It caught our attention, and then I went to go and look at all the, I like to look at all the paperwork that is applicable to a project like this, and all I found was the agenda request, the application with all the not applicables, and nothing else.
So you've been watching it?
We're trying to catch up at the end of the year. You know, it's hard for a volunteer organization to stay on top of every single issue in the county, but we do our best.
How long have you been keeping an eye on it?
I would say since probably August or September. I've been watching the work sessions.
Interesting, Ms. Castro, and the reason I ask that is because as a district commissioner, you know I've been working on it. I've had no contact from your organization at all about this.
Mm-hmm.
So I find it hard to believe that there was that much concern about it. Why didn't you contact me before tonight? Why would we want to penalize somebody that's trying to create jobs and increase property?
We're not trying to penalize anyone at all. You're actually putting words into our...
No, that's my words, but I'm asking, why hadn't you contacted me before?
Because we're a volunteer organization, and this is not something that we do for a living. We don't get paid to do this. We take it on as someone can handle
the opportunity. So in 4 months, you've not had an opportunity to email me and say, would you meet with our group and explain this?
No, and if that's a thorn in your side, I apologize.
Well, it just seems if it was that big of a concern, you would have contacted me.
Anyone else wishing to speak in opposition, please step forward.
My name is Martha Mashburn Lappe. I'm a resident of Forsyth County, and I represent my five brothers and sisters and my three cousins, which own a large piece of property that is a neighbor to this piece of property that you're asking, I mean, that we're talking about tonight. We're not opposed to the M2 zoning concept, but we are to the way that this has been handled. We feel it should face the same scrutiny as all zonings and prove that it can meet the standards that set forth in the UDC. The conditions that we've seen this afternoon, we see nothing in the conditions that require an environmental use or even an eco-industrial park. We feel that we are being... and that you are being asked to approve something that is very vague, sounds lovely, pretty pictures, but really may be a pig in a poke. And we'd like to ask you to please reconsider this. Thank you.
Anyone else wishing to speak in opposition?
Good evening. My name is Andrea Cantrell Jones. I'm an attorney for the James S. Mashburn Trust and Mashburn family, who own the property that is adjacent to this Buckhorn property that the county has initiated rezoning of. My address is 3500 Lennox Road, Suite 760, Atlanta 30326, and I hope I'm being paid for this speaking. This rezoning is the way this rezoning is being handled is very shocking to me. I have never experienced a situation in which a 115-acre project was pre-approved by a local government without making, especially in Forsyth County. I've been involved in rezonings here, and you guys are really tough. Your professional staff is top-notch, and they fly-spec every rezoning, and yet here we are with very little information and with a rezoning that allows an incredible number of noxious uses without any kind of studies or backup except some pretty pictures. One of the things that concerns me is that last week rezoning conditions came out, and those are the rezoning conditions that I mentioned in my letter that you all have to you. And I didn't know about what you were going to get today, which is a whole bunch more conditional use approvals that have not even appeared for public consumption. I just got this when I walked in tonight, and I hope you are aware. Do you have any idea on a conditional use permit to be approved for cement manufacturing? Do you know what cement manufacturing involves? It's a huge burden and impact on the property, on the area. It is just the most intensive industrial you can imagine. And yet, with little or no attention to what is going to happen if a cement plant goes in there, you've approved a conditional use. And these other uses, ash landfill, recycling and recovery facilities, limited and specific solid waste handling. And in that paragraph, I defy anybody to tell me what it means, but I do see solid waste handling in there. So asphalt plant, These, all of these uses are highly intensive and have the potential to destroy the environment and certainly to change the nature and of the area and to deplete all of its resources in addition to the heavy transportation needs. There's been no, I have seen no traffic study. I have seen no estimate of how many trucks are going to go in and out, how these materials are going to be transported. As I say in my letter, I did study up on gypsum a little bit, and it basically recycles drywall, so you're going to have that in there. Plus the zoning conditions would allow the sand mine to continue, so there would be continued blasting. And here I would note that these people have not been prohibited from using their 115 acres all of this time. They've been operating a sand mine, which Mr. Smith, I believe is his name, seems to think has been operated successfully. So they're not being damaged in any way by keeping the use they have. I think that what is telling is the letter that was written by Mr. Smith on October 29th, 2010, to Mr. Tom Brown and Mr. Matt Buchan, who says, and I quote him, he says that because of their connection with Tommy Bagwell, who owns additional acreage, an entire 800-acre industrial node could be formed in that area. All right, this is more than 115 acres. They plan to add American Proteins and make an 800-acre park. Well, that may be nice for the county, but what is, or may not be nice for the county, but it certainly is not going to be nice for the area because it is going to be an intensive, ugly use. It's going to be, if you go into any county that has huge industrial areas with these kinds of uses, you know that it's not a pleasant place to be in, and all of the residential uses will become undesirable and unusable. The other thing that's interesting that Mr. Smith says, he says, well, what ultimate uses we can and should attract certainly remain to be seen, as in any similar master plan rezoning at this early stage of the game. The overall green technology eco-industrial park idea is just an idea in its infancy. They have no end user. They don't have Georgia Tech signed up. They don't have anybody signed up. What they're going to go out there and do is create a landfill under the guise of an eco-park. Now, I think that they may deserve or may merit some kind of zoning, but I think that the proper and rational thing for the county to do is to send this application back to the applicant, let them apply like everybody else does, let them pay the zoning application fee. Why should they be have that fee waived for them? And undergo the scrutiny from the staff and from the public, and then if they pass muster, give them the zoning, give them the conditional use approvals one by one as they meet the requirements and as the county can assure itself that they're not getting into some kind of strange, ugly place that they never anticipated. That is what I would propose. And I think passing this tonight would be your legacy to the county. And if that's how you want to be remembered, I don't really think that's so. I think your legacy, you would want your legacy, those of you who are leaving, those of you who are staying, to be something more that you can be proud of. So what I would request on behalf of the Mashburn Family Trust and the Mashburn James S. Mashburn Trust and the Mashburn family is that you postpone this decision until you get better information. Thank you.
Ms. Cantrell?
Yes.
A couple of things you said I'd like to comment on, please. One of them is I appreciate your compliments of our staff. They are a great staff. Indeed, they're so good that I had them craft these conditions with me and counselor to ensure that they met the needs and the desires of the neighbors. So I appreciate that. They did a great job at it. I believe they did. I think one of the things that is missing here, as you mentioned, that this property is next to American Proteins, a company that's been in this county since 1943, one of our best corporate citizens, as a matter of fact. The hundreds of thousands of dollars that the Bagwell family gives to this community is tremendous. They run a great operation, and it baffles me as to why there's concern about an industrial park in an area that's been classified in an industrial node on our future land use map prior to your client's zoning their residential property. Now, your client's desire to zone their 648 lots next to a chicken rendering plant, next to an industrial node on the future land use map is certainly risky. And I would suggest that that's not something that a landowner that wants to take advantage of product that is in its infancy, that the federal government, the state, and even our own development authority is offering incentives to encourage people to take this business that's in its infancy, because we know that it's the way we're going to have to go. And I appreciate that they want to do that in Forsyth County, that they want to create jobs in Forsyth County, that they want to create additional property tax revenue in Forsyth County. And I'm just baffled at the opposition to it. I've not yet been given any real reason, because, again, your client zoned a residential subdivision next to a chicken plant and a sand mine.
Mr. Bell, may I respond?
Absolutely.
Number one, they are not next to a chicken plant. Okay? Buckhorn property, that 115 acres, is between the Mashburn property and American Proteins. They haven't protested that. They have lived peacefully next door to the sand mine for all of these years.
I think it was in their family at one time, wasn't it? Didn't their family operate this sand mine?
I believe there was some involvement in the sand mine, but that's been way back when the dad was alive. But for the last 12 years, the trust has had the property, and they had calculated how they could build that residential subdivision, which is on a ridge. It overlooks the sand mine, but there's ways that you can buffer and everything so that you don't see the sand mine. But the cement plant?
How are they going to see it?
Pardon?
How would they see it if they're going to buffer the sand mine? Why wouldn't they buffer the cement plant?
Well, a cement plant's a different story than a sand mine. Or how about the medical waste incinerator?
Well, you have to understand.
You know, these are all in there. It's somewhere in there. They're in there. There's no, and you know, how are they going to prevent noxious odors? Has anybody looked into the science of this?
Well, I can tell you that the conditions drafted by staff took that into account. As a matter of fact, the reason these changed, Ms. Jones, is because of your letter. I think it came in late last night, did it not?
Yes.
Yeah, so we did take that and we addressed those concerns that you had, and very clearly have said that they have to comply with all local, state, and federal regulations. They don't have carte blanche. And to insinuate that we've cooked these things up this afternoon and you've not seen them, I've got conditions here for things that are coming up later on that have yet to be seen. This is a normal occurrence. It's not like it's some oddball thing that we're working on zoning conditions up until and even through the public hearings. You're one of the best land use lawyers in the state of Georgia. Your firm is one of the best. You know that conditions are worked on right up to the time the buttons are pushed.
And I also know that generally the commission does not vote when additional conditions are added that the public has not had a chance to vet.
The conditions that were added were in response to your letter of late last night.
Well,
so they were to address your concerns.
Well, they don't.
Well, tell me how.
Well, for instance, adding that limited and specific solid waste handling shall be permitted. That wasn't one of my concerns, because that wasn't one of the additional approved uses.
That's one of the concerns of the people that actually reside nearby, that they do not want a landfill, they do not want a C&D landfill, they don't want a transfer station. The only way I'll permit MSW to come onto that site is in direct use, as it says, I think, in here, that it has to be used in a zero emission, zero odor waste energy process. And that there has to be no discernible odor, and it has to operate with compliance with all pertinent local, state, and federal regulations. What more would you want them to do except comply with federal law?
I would like to see the empirical description of how this is going to be accomplished.
You yourself said this is an industry in its infancy.
No, that's what Mr. Smith said.
Well, you have used that as an argument that we shouldn't do this thing in its infancy because we don't know what it is.
Right.
And I suggest to you that, no, we don't know what it is. But what we have done is protected the concerns that the people that actually live on the property, that live nearby, that we have tried to protect those concerns. Now, there's no way to try to condition every conceivable use that can come along, but I can tell you that as the district commissioner, and I've worked on these with our staff, our great staff, that we've tried to address all of the concerns. I fail to see that there's any concern other than the lawsuits.
Was there any research? Where is the research? Why was it not made available to
what research
the public?
Are you,
the research that goes behind the staff decision that these conditions are good and will work. The second thing is, since when does this county give conditional use permit approvals without going through the process? But this is just, go from he wants it to they'll have it. We're not saying they can't have it. We're saying that they need to do it properly.
Well, they will, and you also commented on traffic and things of that nature. We have not at all waived the DRI process. In fact, we received a letter from Georgia Mountains this afternoon that has indicated that this is okay, it is acceptable, and that they will have to go through the DRI process on things like cement plants. They will still have to go through that process. We can't waive, and again, I want you to understand, because I don't suggest for a minute that we're trying to get around anything. We're not trying to allow them to skirt anything. They will still have to go through each and every regulatory process there is.
Well,
what this allows them to do.
Where's the impact statement that's required by
the impact statement on page 2. If you'll roll that to page 2, you will see that number 4, that everything has to go through.
This has to go through before conditional use can be approved.
We can, and we have it approved with Georgia Mountains, that we can approve the use, but they still have to go through all other checks.
I'm not talking about the DRI, Mr. Bell. I'm talking about the M2 district application requirements for conditional uses. There's an impact statement required. There are a ton of things required. They're not here.
They're required of an applicant. I don't believe they're required in a county-initiated rezoning. And the question that people have about why is this done this way, there's been other county-initiated rezonings done in this county. They're done all over the state of Georgia. You know that. And you know why they're done.
They're done to avoid public involvement. I truly believe this was done to avoid.
So when you come to this county and ask us to do that for one of your clients, you would expect us to not do
I don't
it?
Believe I've ever asked
you
a county to initiate a zoning. By the rules.
Well,
and I
these are the rules, Ms. Jones. These are the rules that the state of Georgia allows us to operate under. We're not doing anything illegal here.
Well, you may not be doing anything illegal, but I do think that what you're doing does not inspire public confidence.
Well, we have had a public participation meeting in Chesapeake. We have invited your client to sit down with the owners of this property, to which they have not. They have sent you a letter regarding the lawsuit, to which you declined. We have reached out. I say we because we're the applicant, but you have been reached out to. And
well,
you have failed to reach back.
We beg to differ. We think that the applicant, who is not the applicant, Buckhorn, has not made any attempt to reach out and is just hiding behind this lawsuit that they brought, and in which they say that the sand mine can't operate if the residential property is there, the residential zoning holds.
I've got a letter of August 13th that invites your client to come sit down, to which you yourself, I would hope, drafted this letter declining 6 days later on August 19th.
I sent him a number of conditions that we would agree to
and
settle.
And declined to sit down.
And
it's here.
You know, Mr. Bell, you know, if you were there, this history has been going on for 2006.
You're right, it has.
And
we're going to allow this property owner, I would hope, to do something worthwhile with their property that's going to help this county, that has nothing to do with a lawsuit between your client and them. We're not party to that lawsuit. That's a lawsuit between the two of them. They have offered to withdraw that lawsuit. Your client has declined. Your client's declined to sit down and talk to them. I'm sorry.
That is not so. They have not offered to withdraw the lawsuit to us.
On August 13th, there was a letter to withdraw the lawsuit. I'm sorry.
Mr. Laughinghouse doesn't want this argument.
I believe that this is probably gone on long enough.
Well, we have to at least be straightforward, Mr. Chairman. And there's a letter right here that indicates that says we will withdraw with prejudice the lawsuit. It is right here, and your response declines it.
Well, if my response asks for certain other conditions,
it declined.
But that has
offer.
Nothing to do with this. This
Ms.
is about
you have
a county
said that
action.
They did not offer to withdraw, and I'm saying they did.
Well, they didn't
have
offer.
Tried to work with your client. I'm
well,
sorry.
I will differ with you. I've been in this since 2006, and I will tell you, work with my client is not something that they have been willing to do, and you don't agree, and so we just don't agree.
Well, I've just got the letter from you declining,
well,
Ms.
that's
Jones.
Well, that's a piece of a bigger piece, a piece of a bigger conversation between the Mashburns and Buckhorn.
Well, the information that I have where they have offered to withdraw the lawsuit and to work with your client and invited them to sit down and go through all of this was declined.
Well.
So I'm sorry. I mean, that's all I have.
That's fine.
Thank you.
Trying to get my breath after that.